So today's another topic is factor theorem. Factor theorem means if p of x is a polynomial of degree n is greater than or equal to 1 and a is any real number, then x minus a is a factor of p of x if p of a is equal to 0. And again another condition is if p of a is equal to 0, then if x minus a is a factor of p of x, that means we will discuss one example regarding this factor theorem. Now, x plus 2 is a factor of x cube plus 2x square plus 3x plus 6. Now, we have to see whether it is a factor or not. Check whether x plus 2 is a factor of x cube plus 2x square plus 3x plus 6. Now, first of all, this one we can assume let p of x be x cube plus 2x square plus 3x plus 6. Now, here x plus 2 is a 0 of the linear polynomial. So, the 0 of the linear polynomial of x plus 2 is minus 2. Here, how you look at this minus 2 means x plus 2 is equal to 0, x equal to minus 2. Now, p of in place of x, substitute that value minus 2. Minus 2 cube plus 2 into minus 2 square plus 3 into minus 2 plus 6. Now, minus 2 cube is nothing but minus 8. Plus 2 in here, we should not multiply directly. Why? Because here power is there. So, first of all, simplify that power. Minus 2 square is nothing but we will get 4. Whenever minus symbol is there, if the power is in even number, then this minus becomes plus. 2 into 4 plus into minus minus. Why? Because here there is no power. So, you can do directly. Minus 6 plus 6. Now, minus 8, 2 4s are 8, minus 6 plus 6. Now, plus 8, minus 8 get cancelled. And again, minus 6 plus 6 get cancelled. So, you get 0. So, here the result is 0, isn't it? So, therefore, by factor theorem, we can say that x plus 2 is a factor of x cube plus 2x square plus 3x plus 6. Therefore, by factor theorem, we can say that x plus 2 is a factor of x cube plus 2x square plus 3x plus 6. Then we'll go to another example. Now the another sum is find the value of k if x plus 3 is a factor of 3x square plus 4kx plus 6. But in this problem they have given that x plus 3 is a factor. Now, let p of x equal to 3x square plus kx plus 6. The 0 of the linear polynomial of x plus 3 is minus 3. Here, how you get minus 3 means x plus 3 is equal to 0, then x equal to minus 3. Now, here they have given that x plus 3 is a factor. Already they have given the problem itself. So, that's why now in place of x, we have to substitute this minus 3. So, p of minus 3 is equal to 3 into minus 3 square plus k into minus 3 plus 6 is equal to 0. Here, why you should keep is equal to 0 means in the problem they have given that x plus 3 is a factor of 3x square plus kx plus 6. That means remainder is nothing but 0. Whenever the object is a factor, then compulsory we have to keep 0. Why? Because remainder is nothing but 0. Now, 3 into 3 square minus 3 square is nothing but 9. Plus into minus, minus, minus 3k plus 6 is equal to 0. Now, 3 9s, 27 minus 3k plus 6 is equal to 0. Now, 27 plus 6 is nothing but 33. 33 minus 3k is equal to 0. Now, this minus 3k is on the set. It becomes plus 3k. 3k is equal to 33. That means k is equal to 33 by 3. So, the value of k is nothing but 11. That means here, why you should keep 0 whenever they argue that x plus 3 is a factor of not only x plus 3, if any number, that means for example, take x plus 4, x plus 5 or x minus 5, anything. It is a, in the problem itself, they have given, if they have given like x plus 3 is a factor like that means, then compulsory we have to keep remainder is equal to 0. So that's why here we have to keep 0. According to factor theorem, so we have to prove that the value of k, that means 3 into minus 3 square plus k into minus 3 plus 6 is equal to 0. That means wherever x is there means in place of x we have to substitute that minus 3. Here why should keep only minus 3? Why? Because the 0 of the linear polynomial of x plus 3 is nothing but minus 3. So in place of x we have to substitute that value. So 3 9 27 minus 3k plus 6 is equal to 0. Now here these two are plus term, plus values. That means 27 plus 6, 33 minus 3k is equal to 0. This minus 3k center side becomes plus 3k. So 3k is equal to 33. 3 is multiplied, it becomes divide. 33 by 3 is nothing but 11. Therefore, the value of k is nothing but 11. Show that x minus 2, x plus 3 and x minus 4 are factors of x cube minus 3x squared minus 10x plus 24. So here we have to show that whether this one belongs to factor or not. For example, take x minus 2. With the help of x minus 2, if we get 0, then x minus 2 is a factor of x cube minus 3x squared minus 10x plus 24. Like that, we have to show. Now, first of all, simplify this one. Let f of x is equal to x cube minus 3x squared minus 10x plus 24. Now, what the first one? X minus 2. The 0 of the linear polynomial linear polynomial of x minus 2 is 2. Now, in place of x, we have to substitute 2. Minus 3 into 2 square minus 10 into 2 plus 24. Now 2 cube is nothing but 8 minus 3 into 2 square is nothing but 4 minus 10 to 0 20 plus 24. Now 8 minus 3 4 0 12 minus 20 plus 24. Now, first of all, take the plus values. Here, what are the plus values? 24 and 8. 24 plus 8, 32. Now, in minus symbols, if more than one minus symbol is there, means then we can add and keep minus symbol only. So, minus 12, minus 20. Minus into minus, plus. So, 20 and 12, 32. So, bigger number is minus 32. Is equal to 0. So, by simplifying here, we got 0, isn't it? Therefore, x minus 2 is a factor of x cube minus 3x squared minus 10x plus 24. Similarly, we have to simplify same like that only. Now, another one is x plus 3. So, the 0 of linear polynomial of x plus 3 is minus 3. Here, how do you write minus 3? 0 of the linear polynomial is nothing but here we have keep is equal to 0. Then plus 3 center side becomes minus 3. Now, f of minus 3 is equal to, so in place of x, we have to substitute that minus 3. Minus 3 cube minus 3 into minus 3 square minus 10 into minus 3 plus 24. Now, minus 3 cube is nothing but minus 27. Here we should not simplify minus into minus. Why? Because here power is there. First of all, simplify this one. Minus 3 into 9. Here there is no power. We can simplify directly. Minus into minus plus 10 threes are 30 plus 24. Now -27 plus 30 plus 24. Here both are minus. So -27 minus 27 will get -54. So -54 plus 30 plus 24, 54. So -54 plus 54 is nothing but 0. So we can say that x plus 3 is also factor of x cube minus 3x square minus 10x plus 24. Similarly for x minus 4, the zero of the linear polynomial of x minus 4 is 4. That means P of 4 or F of 4, anything we can write. F of 4 is equal to, now in place of x, we can keep 4. 4 cube minus 3 into 4 square minus 10 into 4 plus 24. Here f of x is there, isn't it? We can write either f of x or p of x, both are same only. Now, 4 cube is nothing but 64 minus 3 into 4 square is nothing but 16 minus 40 plus 24. Now, 48 minus 40 plus 24. Here, what are the plus values? 64 and 24. That means you will get 88. Minus 48 minus 40. That means both are in minus. So, if we add means you will get 88. So, bigger number is minus. 88 is equal to 0. Therefore, x minus 2 comma x plus 3 and x plus 4 are the factors of x cube minus 3x square minus 10x plus 24. Now, the another topic is factorize x cube minus 2x square minus x plus 2. Generally, here quadratic equation means we have three terms. For example, x square minus x plus 2 or x square minus 3x plus 6, like that. Any, that means if three terms are there, then we can do factors for that one. But here, the factors are four terms. Cube, square, x and then constant term. Here, the power is, that means the degree is 3. So, that's why we can say that it is a cubic polynomial. Now, let P of x is equal to x cube minus 2x square minus x plus 2. First of all, here see the constant term. Which one is constant term? 2 is a constant term. So for that one, we have to do factors. Here, what are the factors of 2, 1 and 2? So while writing, we can write plus or minus 1 and plus or minus 2. For example, by trial. Trial is nothing but we can guess any number among, that means between these two numbers. So by trial, first of all we find P of 1. So, in place of x, substitute that value 1. Now, 1 cube minus 2 into 1 square minus 1 plus 2. Here, 1 cube is nothing but 1 minus 2 into 1 square is nothing but 1 minus 1 plus 2. Now, 1 minus 2 minus 1 plus 2. Now see, plus 1 minus 1 get cancelled. Minus 2 plus 2 also get cancelled. So here the value is 0. Then we can say that x minus 1 is a factor. Why we have to say x minus 1 is a factor? Why? Because if the 0 of the linear polynomial of x minus 1 is 1. So that's why here we wrote 1. See, how we get 1? With the help of the 0 of the linear polynomial of x minus 1. So we can say that x minus 1 is a factor of x cube minus 2x square minus x plus 2. Now x minus 1 is a factor, isn't it? So with the help of x minus 1, we have to do division method. X cube minus 2x square minus x plus 2. Now here, what's the which one is the first term? X cube. So divide by x, that means x cube by x will get x square. So write that x square here. After writing this one, x into x square, x cube minus 1 into x square minus x square. Here plus becomes minus, and again minus becomes plus. Do the cancellation. Now this one is minus 2 and this one is plus. You should not say minus, plus. So minus into plus, minus. So minus 2 plus 1 will get minus 1 x square minus x. Or minus 1 x square or x square, both are same only. Now here which one is the first term? Minus x square. So minus x square by x will get minus x. X into x, x square minus x square. Minus into minus, plus x. Now, and again we have to see this plus 2 also. Now see this one, minus x square minus x. X into x, minus x square, minus into minus, plus x. Then here change the symbols. Minus becomes plus becomes minus. Now these two get cancelled. So minus x, minus x, minus 2x plus 2. But again here which one is the first term? Minus 2x. Minus 2x by x. X is get cancelled. So you will get minus 2. Now see this one. X into minus 2. Minus 2x. Minus into minus. Plus 2, 1 is 2. Change the symbols. Minus becomes plus. Plus becomes minus. So we get cancellation means we get the remainder is 0. Therefore, after getting this 0, then here what are the which one is factors? So x square minus x minus 2. It is a quadratic polynomial, isn't it? So for this one, we have to do the factorization. Minus 2 into x square minus 2x square. So what are the factors of minus 2? That means, now see this one, minus into plus, minus. So minus 2 plus 1 will get minus x. So with the help of this one, if you simplify means, compulsate the middle value, if you will get same value only. How like means, now see this one is minus, this one is plus, minus into plus, minus. This one is completed. After completing this one, minus 2x plus 1x is nothing but minus x. That means this one is suitable for this one. So x square minus 2x plus x minus 2. In this one, take x as a common. So x minus 2. Now plus 1 into x minus 2. Why? Because here the decimal number means 1. Anything multiple by 1 will get x minus 2 only. Now here x minus 2 and x minus 2 both are common, isn't it? So x minus 2 into x plus 1. Therefore, factors are x minus 1 is a factor, isn't it? Therefore, factors are x minus 1, x minus 2, and x plus 1. Now, in this one only, another method also is there. Now, another method is, now, the question is, factorize x square, x cube minus 2x square minus x plus 2. Let P of x is equal to x cube minus 2x square minus x plus 2. Here, in another method, sum of quotient of x. Quotient of x means, before x there is no number means 1. So write that 1. Before x square is minus 2. And then before x, minus 1 plus 2 is equal to 0. Here one condition is there. What's that condition means? If the sum of the quotient of x is 0, then x minus 1 is a factor of p of x. We can write directly. So 0 of the linear polynomial of x minus 1 is minus 1. Here, having that minus 1, x minus 1 is equal to 0, x equal to 1. 0 of x minus 1 or 0 of linear polynomial of x minus 1 is same only. Therefore, 0 of x minus 1 is 1. Now, August method, we can say this method is also called as synthetic method. Here, first of all, write this one, x cube, x square, x and again constant term. Here, c is nothing but constant term. Now, before x cube, there is no number means 1. Write that 1 as it is only. And again, before x square, what's the number? Minus 2. Write that minus 2. Before x, there is no number means 1. But here, what's the symbol? Minus. So, write that minus 1. Then, which one is constant? 2. Write that 1 as it is only. So, while doing this Euler's method, here, what the value we got? 1. Therefore, write x equal to 1. For the first place, we have to keep 0. Now, 1 plus 0 is nothing but 1. Write that 1 as it is only. Now, here, how we get this 1 means, first of all, take the first step is, 1 plus 0 is nothing but 1. Now, here 1 is there, isn't it? So, with this 1, we have to multiply this 1. So, 1 into 1, 1. Minus 2 plus, here there is no symbol means plus. Minus into plus, minus. So, you will get minus 1. And again, after completing, after getting this 1, 1 into minus 1 will get minus 1. Here, minus 1, minus 1, minus 2. Why? Because both are minus. Whenever both are minus symbols means, we can add and keep minus symbol directly. Now, 1 into minus 2 will get minus 2. Now, 2 minus 2, 0. Compulsory for the last value should get 0. So, this one is nothing but reminder. After completing this one, now see this one. First one is 1. This can be written as x square, 1x square in the form of quadratic equation. So, 1. 1 is nothing but 1 square. 1 square is the 1x square. 1x square minus 1x minus 2. 1x square or x both are same only. Minus 1x or x both are same only. So, we can write as x square minus x minus 2. Then, do the factorization. Now, if we'll do factorization means, we'll get, now see this one, minus 2x square can be written as minus 2x plus 1x. Minus into plus minus. 2 minus 1 minus 1. So, x square minus 2x plus x minus 2. In this 2, take x as a common. So, x into x minus 2 plus 1 into x minus 2. Here, which one is common? X minus 2 is a common. X minus 2 into x plus 1. Therefore, the factors of x cube minus 2x square minus x plus 2 are x minus 1, x plus 1 and x minus 2. This one is another method in factorization of cubic polynomial. Now, another sum is, if ax square plus bx plus c and bx square plus ax plus c have a common factor x plus 1, then show that c is equal to 0 and a is equal to b. Here, the first one is let f of x equal to ax square plus bx plus c. The 0 of the linear polynomial of x plus 1 is minus 1. That means, in place of x, substitute that value minus 1. A into minus 1 square plus b into minus 1 plus c. Here, minus 1 square is nothing but 1. Plus into minus, minus b plus c. So, a minus b plus c. Therefore, they have given that x plus 1 is a factor of f of x. So, remainder is equal to 0. Here, have you got 0? Why? Because in the problem, they have given that x plus 1 is a factor of f of x. So, remainder is equal to 0. Therefore, a minus b plus c is equal to 0. Similarly, then this one we can assume that g of x equal to bx square plus ax plus c. Here also the 0 of the x linear polynomial of x plus 1 is minus 1. So, g of minus 1 is equal to b into minus 1 square plus a into minus 1 plus c. So, minus 1 square is nothing but 1. B into 1 plus into minus, minus a plus c. In this problem, also they have given that x plus 1 is a factor of g of x. Therefore, remainder is equal to 0. So, b minus a plus c is equal to 0. From equation 1 and 2, we can write that a minus b plus c is equal to b minus a plus c. Now, plus c get cancelled. That means here in middle symbol is equal to. Then we can do cancellation directly. C get cancelled. So, a minus b is equal to b minus a. Now, this minus a sentence becomes plus a. And again, this minus b sentence becomes plus b. 2a is equal to 2b. 2 get cancelled. A is equal to b. Now, here s cube is nothing but substitute. Substitute a is equal to b in equation 1. So, here what are in place of a? We can write b. That means b minus b plus c is equal to 0. Then plus b minus b get cancelled. Therefore, c is equal to 0. Now, as per sum, we have to prove that c is equal to 0 and a is equal to b.